we are seeing organised gangs using drones to monitor movements of police on borders for illegal immigration. They're also using drones to disrupt day-to-day operations of an airport or of a power station. We came up with 10 standardized scenarios. So the scenarios were like incursions into airports, incursions into prisons, drones above public mass events and stuff like that. So what we did was we looked at these scenarios based on the threat analysis that we did, and then we developed the methodology that you would require to have CUAS in place for these scenarios. So for example, you wouldn't use the same system at a prison as you would use at an airport, because the technology would need to be different, because the environment is always different, because of the digital signatures that are currently in existence in those scenarios would be different.
Para conseguir que las fuerzas y cuerpos de seguridad tengan los medios ideales para poder combatir este tipo de actividad delictiva, existen iniciativas, entre ellas, para nosotros una de las más importantes es el proyecto Corallius. Policía Nacional participa en el proyecto Corallius desde el inicio, en todas las fases que se ha ido desarrollando, tanto en las fases de planeamiento y diseño como en las fases de desarrollo práctico.
A buyer really doesn't know how that kit is going to perform until they use it for quite some time. And if it's not the right kit, then it's misplaced investment they can't recover from. I find that what Interpol is doing from a Project Courageous perspective is second to none in the world right now. They're leading a charge not to what the right answer is, but how do you find the right answer? Since it's never been done before, that is the necessary step to get to answers later on. And so I think without Project Courageous, we'd be a lot worse off.
There's so many good things that can be done with drones. It would be a shame to be, you know, stopped by criminals or non-state actors that want to leverage the drones for less good things.
We're not worried about the drone because the drone can't do anything. It's the pilot flying it that can do it. So we are constantly asking law enforcement, locate the pilot, because it's the pilot that's being bad. It's not the drone. The drone is only doing what it has been told to do.